For our senior citizens and women travelers, we increase quota of lower berths in the coming financial year. We are increasing the senior citizen quota per coach by 50%, resulting in almost 120 lower berths per train for senior citizens. We added more escalators and lifts, reserved more middle bays in coaches for movement security. We introduced Wi-Fi services at stations, especially for our youth and business travelers. The process has begun. We intend to commission Wi-Fi services at 100 stations this year and 400 more stations in the next 2 years. We are partnering with Google in this endeavor. I take this opportunity to invite all other service providers and entrepreneurs to partner with us in this initiative. The passenger experience is significantly governed by the efficiency and quality of services on the railway stations. Besides improvement in service, a redeveloped railway station would also provide opportunities for generating significant non-tariff revenues. We are redeveloping our stations using different models. Based on one of these models, the contract for redevelopment of first station Habibganj in Bhopal, for which the financial bid has been received, while 4 others are in a very advanced stage of bidding. In a landmark decision, Cabinet has approved redevelopment of 400 stations through PPP. This is expected to be the largest transit-oriented development in the world and hence involves complex decision-making. On the basis of a bankable structure for private partnership, it is proposed to undertake a bidding process for a few large and medium stations during the course of the next financial year. Apart from taking up stations through PPP mode, we are also exploring the possibility of availing multilateral financial investment for the development of several other stations with the state governments. We are making a unique attempt to combine cleanliness with creativity. I had appealed to numerous social organizations to come forward to beautify our stations. I am happy to inform that walls of many stations have been converted to murals, which have not only improved the aesthetics but also spread awareness on socially relevant themes. One such theme that deserves special mention is wildlife conservation, illustrated to the paintings done at Sawai Madhopur station. Hazaribagh, Borivali, Khar, Udaipur, Bikaner, of some of other stations, we showcase local art and talent. I thank them all and request similar support next year for aesthetic upgradation of our stations. To provide better security to our passengers, especially women travelers, All India 24/7 helpline number 182 was started, CCTV surveillance provided at 311 stations, and all major stations will be brought under CCTV surveillance in a phased manner. A single accident or loss of a single life causes me great sorrow and anguish. It also demonstrates that we'll have to go a long way to go in realizing our objective of a zero accident regime. Although our safety record is better at 20% lower accident this year as compared to the previous year, there is much more that is required to be done. I truly believe that a way forward is to eliminate accident is through adoption and assimilation of latest technology. We have entered into R&D partnership with leading railway institutions of the world, Railway Technical Research Institute of Japan, Korean Railway Research Institute. They will work with us to improve operations on existing network and hence provide a roadmap for zero accident railway system in India. In the interim, we have examined the recommendations of the committee headed by Dr. Kakodkar and are working on their implementation. We are also working on anti-fouling measures for overcrowded trains, mainly in the suburban sections. In 2015-16, we have closed 350 unmanned level crossings and eliminated 1,000 unmanned level crossings. 820 ROBs and RUBs have been completed in the current year, and work is going on 1,350 more. In my last budget speech, I had promised annualized saving of rupees 3,000 crores to be achieved by the third year on energy. I am happy to announce that a target will be achieved in the next financial year itself, a year earlier than envisaged. For the first time, we leverage provisions of the Electricity Act to procure power directly at competitive rates using our status as deemed distribution licenses. Power procurement contracts already signed and implemented will mean an annualized saving of rupees 1,300 crores. Further actions to source power already initiated will deliver annualized saving of 1,700 crores during the coming year, taking the total to rupees 3,000 crores. In addition, the saving of rupees 300 crores is being targeted through demand side management and energy efficiency. Locomotives with auxiliary load are now being manufactured by us, use of these locos will enable elimination of power cars, thereby replacing them with passenger coaches, which will enhance the carrying capacity of 10 and significantly reduce the travel time, noise level, fuel consumption and carbon footprint. 4 such locos have been turned in the current financial year and another 39 are expected in the next year. Rail University is an important enabler to build sustained flow of skilled manpower, a prime requisite for any world-class railway system. We identified the National Academy of Indian Railways at Vadodara as a first institution which will be upgraded to a full-fledged university. Preparations are in full swing to establish the university during this year. As an organization, we cannot progress on the path of prosperity unless the path is digitally illuminated. This year, an application of TAC management system was launched. With this, activities of TAC inspection, monitoring and maintenance has thus been switched over to an IT platform. And automatic alerts in the form of SMS and emails are being generated. Inventory management module of TMS has resulted in inventory reduction of 27,000 metric ton, resulting in a saving of 64 crores and scrap identification of 22,000 metric ton, equivalent to 53 crores. During this year, the system will be implemented throughout the railway network. We have developed an application for maintaining centralized land data and records of all land holding that we have now been digitized. As I move on to illustrate the new initiative, let me take a step back. One of the thrust areas of last year's budget was giving passengers better services and making railway journeys enjoyable. We'll continue to build on this momentum and strive hard to ensure satisfaction of each of the 7 billion passengers that ride railway's network annually. Ours is a common man's government, working tirelessly for the benefit of all, especially farmers, workers, women, disabled and the impoverished. Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas is not just a slogan for us, it pervades all our thoughts and actions. Every customer is our brand ambassador, the very reasons of our existence. Therefore, each time that he or she travels, the satisfaction quotient must go up. In pursuance of making each of our customers happy, I propose to take the following measures. For the unreserved passengers, we'll start, this is a new product, not a train, this will be there all over, Antyodaya Express and Deen Dayalu coaches. This government truly believes that the fate of India would not change unless the lives of the common man or woman improve. Not only he or she is a center point of policy making, but is ubiquitous to our public discourse and in our ideology. We propose to introduce Antyodaya Express, a long-distance, fully unreserved superfast train service for the common man to be operated on dense routes. We will also add 2 or 4 Deen Dayalu coaches in some long-distance trains for unreserved travel to enhance our carrying capacity for the masses. These coaches will also have facility for potable drinking water and higher number of mobile charging points. For the reserved passengers, we are starting 3 new products: Humsafar, Tejas and Uday. I am announcing 3 TRELEX services to ensure cost recovery by way of tariff and non-tariff measures. Humsafar would be fully air-conditioned third AC service with an optional service for meals. Tejas, on the other hand, will showcase the future of train travel in India, operating at a speed of 130 kilometers per hour and above. It will offer onboard services such as entertainment, local cuisine, Wi-Fi, etc. through one service provider for ensuring accountability and improved customer satisfaction. We'll also introduce overnight double-decker Uday Express on the busiest route, which has the potential to increase carrying capacity by almost 40%. To continue the efforts in minimizing waiting time for passengers at booking windows, we intend to commence sale of tickets through handheld terminals for the benefit of the suburban and short-distance travelers. This should enable us to deploy multiple point of sales with minimum infrastructure. We also intend initiating sale of platform tickets through ticket vending machine, which will be made compatible with not only cash but also credit and debit cards. In the next 3 months, we will open the e-ticketing facility for foreign debit and credit card holders, particularly for the foreign tourists and the NRIs. For our journalist friends, we will provide e-booking of tickets on the concessional passes available to them. This has been a long-pending request, and it is my privilege to provide them with this service hoping that they will cover it better. Cancellation of PRS tickets requires a passenger to travel to a booking window to avail the refund within a prescribed time. This is a source of great discomfort. We will now open the facility of cancellation through the 139 helpline, post-verification using one-time password sent to registered phone members. We will introduce barcoded tickets, scanners and access control on a pilot basis on major station to tackle the menace of ticketless travel and ensure hassle-free travel for the genuine passengers. We have taken a number of measures to improve service during the morning tatkal hours, yet there are complaints of rightful passengers being denied train tickets. We therefore intend to progressively ensure CCTV coverage at all tatkal counters. We plan to institutionalize a system of third-party periodic audits and certification of security features of the PRS website so it cannot be hacked. The Vikal Alternative Train Accommodation System scheme, introduced in October 2015, will be expanded to provide choice of accommodation in specific trains to wait-listed passengers. This has been a great response from the people and we want to increase it. Taking forward the momentum on Swachh Rail, Swachh Bharat, we intend taking a string of measures to improve the cleaner stations and trains. Introducing Clean My Coach service, which is already there, on pan-India basis, where a passenger can request cleaning of the coach or a toilet on a demand through SMS, so then instantly the service will be provided. Ranking of A1 and A-class stations based on a regular periodic third-party audit and feedback from passengers. Setting up of a waste segregation and recycling centers at A1 category station in a phased manner. 5 centers to be commissioned in the next financial year itself. Undertaking awareness campaign, installing additional 30,000 bio-toilets, providing portable structures with bio-toilets at all platforms for select stations for senior citizens, divyang and women. Catering has been one of the main issues and also source of satisfaction as well as complaint. Catering has been an important parameter for customer satisfaction. In pursuit of our objective to provide quality food to our customers, the following measures are taken. IRCTC would begin to manage catering services in a phased manner. IRCTC will unbundle catering services by creating a distinction primarily between food preparation and food distribution. Extending e-catering service from the existing 45 large stations to all 408 A1 and A-class stations. Explore the possibility of making mandatory catering service optional in train. Local cuisine of choice will be made available to the passengers. Adding 10 more IRCTC operated mechanized sophisticated base kitchen to ensure fresh and hygienic supply of food on train. Mandating third-party audit in order to ensure desired level of quality in catering services. Introducing a new policy of multi-purpose as against existing single-purpose stalls at stations where each stall can provide multiple services required by passengers including milk products and OTC medicines. Enforcing reservation in catering unit to scheduled cars, scheduled types, other backward classes, women, divyang, etc. We will also introduce a sub-quota of 33% for women in each of the reserved category. Further, to build local ownership and employment, a process of giving weightage to district domicile holders for commercial licenses at stations would be initiated, as we have seen in the past that one contractor could track all the stalls. We are going to be also using all the technical halls as commercial halls on the long distance train. We have introduced Sarthi Seva in Konkan Railway to help the old and disabled passengers requiring assistance at stations. We will expand this service at many more stations. We will strengthen the existing service for enabling passengers to book battery-operated cars, porter services on a paid basis in addition to the existing pickup and drop and wheelchair services. For the divyang and with the objective of Accessible India campaign, we will ensure that all stations under redevelopment are accessible to divyang. We will make efforts to provide at least one divyang-friendly toilet in each platform in A1 class station during this financial year and the next financial year, and also ensure availability of wheelchairs in sufficient numbers at these stations. There is a continuous effort on our part to ensure safe and secure travel for our passengers. Yet untoward incidents occur. To minimize the financial loss to passengers from such events, we are working with insurance companies to offer optional travel insurance for rail journeys at the time of booking itself. Passengers transiting in our network now could book on hourly basis the retiring rooms that are available. Madam, we are starting a Janani Seva. We would like to mitigate the hardship that mothers undergo while travelling with their infants, and for that purpose, we will pilot availability of children's menu items on train. Further, baby foods, hot milk and hot water would be made available on stations, and changing boards for babies would be provided in train toilets. With a view to enhancing passenger comfort, we are planning to reimagine the design and layout of our coaches to ensure higher carrying capacity, provision of new amenities including automatic doors, barcoded readers, bio-vacuum toilets, water level indicators, accessible dustbins, ergonomic seating, improved aesthetics, vending machines, entertainment screens, LED lit boards for advertising, public announcement system and more. These new smart coaches would cater to emerging needs of our customers and to also ensure lower unit cost of operation due to higher carrying capacity. Presently, we have different digital solutions for ticketing, grievance redressal and other issues. We intend to integrate all such facilities into two mobile apps only, one dealing with ticketing issues and other on redressal and suggestion system. Bharatiya Rail is persistently innovating to ensure responsiveness to customer requirement in all our actions. Toward this end, we are making arrangement for skilling our front-ended staff, those we employ through service providers. The uniforms of all customer-facing roles will be refurbished to clearly distinguish them on our network. We'll install information boards in trains, enumerating onboard service, also GPS-based digital displays inside coaches to provide real-time information regarding in upcoming halts. This service will be provided through private sector engagement. Work is underway on installation of a high-tech centralized network of 20,000 screens across 2,000 stations known as Rail Display Network. This will enable real-time flow of information to passengers and also unlock huge advertising potential. We intend to strengthen the organization at the stations with a view to ensuring better passenger amenities, vigilant and sensitive customer service, responsive grievance redressal system. All A1 stations will now be manned with a duly empowered station directors, supported by cross-functional teams who will run the station as excellence center for customers. We'll also make one person accountable for all facilities on a train. The great places of pilgrimage in India have a natural attraction for the Indian traveler. We intend taking up on priority the provision of passenger amenities and beautification on stations at pilgrimage center, including, and not all, but including Ajmer, Amritsar, Biar Sharif, Chengannur, Dwarka, Gaya, Haridwar, Mathura, Nagapattinam, Nanded, Nasik, Pali, Parshnath, Puri, Tirupati, Vailanakani, Varanasi and Vasco. We also intend to run Asta circuit trains to connect important pilgrimage centers. Last year, I had announced development of satellite terminals at a few locations. We take the next level to have several more. I appeal to all states to come forward and to partner with us in line with more. This will help us to provide many more services to the people, so I request all the partners. Porters play a key role in making our journeys comfortable. We intend providing them with a new uniforms and train them for soft skills in line with the evolving image of railway. Adopting modern technology yet traditional in its ethos, also explore methods of offering them group insurance facility. Henceforth, we will be happy to call them as Sahayak. So they will not be called as Kuli, they will be called as Sahayak. A high-speed passenger corridor from Ahmedabad to Mumbai is being undertaken with assistance from the Government of Japan. A special-purpose vehicle for implementing high-speed projects is being registered this month. The prime benefit of this project will be providing us with technology advancement and new manufacturing capability, which will be leveraged for all other areas of the existing network. We propose to invite FM radio stations for providing train-borne entertainment by installing PA systems in trains. Bilingual onboard magazine Rail Bandhu, which is available in Shatabdi, Rajdhani and Duronto, would be extended to all reserved classes of travelers in all mail express trains. We'll also initiate publishing Rail Bandhu in all regional languages. Mumbai is the financial capital of India and needs a robust transport system. However, the suburban railway system in lifeline of the city is overstressed. In principle, approval of MUTP 3 has just been received from NITI Aayog to move forward. We are working towards achieving the financial closure and early award of tenders for two elevated suburban corridors between Churchgate and Virar and Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus to Panvel. The Panvel CSTM Panvel corridor will be integrated with metro lines being planned by the state government for connecting existing Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport and proposed Navi Mumbai International Airport. We intend to raise all low-level platforms in Mumbai suburban station in the ensuing financial year to address safety concerns on this account. In Kolkata, we have ongoing metro works of around 100 kilometers, which when completed would quadruple the installed capacity. I have resolved all issues related to east-west corridor at Kolkata metro, and I am happy to announce that phase one of this project would be completed by June 2018. We are working on the possibility of extending the east-west corridor by another 5 kilometers. Delhi, our national capital, is under severe stress from rising pollution level and can be provided relief by reviving the ring railway system comprising of 21 stations. We will partner with the state government to develop this infrastructure. We intend to undertake major programs to build an integrated suburban ecosystem for railways by launching a new investment framework. We would share equity contribution with the state governments and ensure cost neutrality on operations. We'll come out with a detailed policy in this regard in the next 4 months. We intend to partner with the state governments of Gujarat, Telangana, Tamil Nadu for development of suburban sections in Ahmedabad, Hyderabad, Chennai, respectively, by deploying innovative financing mechanism. Bangalore, the technology hub of the country, warrants comprehensive suburban system. We will partner with the state government in this endeavor. Similar structures of financing mechanism will be created for Thiruvananthapuram, the capital of God's own country, Kerala. I appeal to the state government, and this is a very serious issue, I appeal to all the state governments to work towards staggering of office timing to reduce the peak load on suburban traffic and also avoid accident. Let me turn to traffic, two-thirds of the revenue. Winning back the lost model share, we have lost a lot of it over the years, freight traffic. The model share of Indian Railway has been consistently declining over a long period of time. This trend has had a negative impact not only on the railways, but on the entire economy. We are determined to reverse this slide. There are three solutions for this issue: expanding the freight basket, rationalizing the tariff structure, and building terminal capacity. The freight basket is dominated by 10 bulk commodities, which enjoy a share of 88%. We need to look beyond this to expand the revenue base. A full-fledged market study is being undertaken, and on the basis of this, we'll make sure that we recapture the asset. And we are already working on the scenarios, service level, infrastructure requirement, and action plan is being created to recapture that traffic through either containerization of new delivery models or on roll-on, roll-off will be developed and implemented. Network capacity limitations do not allow us to run timetable freight trains. But from this year, we will start a timetable freight container, parcel and special commodity train on a pilot basis. Container sector would be open to all traffic barring coal and specified mineral ones, and part loads would be permitted during the non-peak season. All existing terminal sheds would be granted access to container traffic where considered feasible. The current tariff structure has led to outpricing of our services in the freight market. A review of tariff policy will be undertaken to evolve a comprehensive rate structure vis-a-vis other modes, permit multi-point loading, and apply differentiated tariff to increase utilization of alternate routes. The possibility of signing long-term tariff contracts with our key freight customers using predetermined price escalation principles will be explored, which will provide predictability of revenues to us and cost to our customers. Inadequate warehousing and transportation is also one of the costs that keep potential customers away from us. In order to complete the chain of transportation, it is proposed to develop rail-side logistic park and warehousing. These logistic parks and warehouses would be created in PPP mode to bring the required efficiency and investment, but also attract greater traffic to the railways. With the coming in of transport logistic company, we will be witness to a paradigm shift in our role as a national logistic provider. The focus will be on providing last mile connectivity for freight business at reduction in logistic cost. At least 10 goods sheds will be developed by Transloc in this year, next current year, financial year, 16-17. To capture the automobile traffic, we'll soon inaugurate India's first rail auto hub in Chennai, probably in next few days itself. This push on rail side warehousing would also encourage development of cold storage facilities on vacant land near freight terminals. Local farmers and fishermen would be given preferential usage to this facility. A policy of this regard will be issued in the next 3 months. We'll appoint key customer managers to liaison with our major freight stakeholders. They would serve as a single point of contact for all communication and redressal with these key customers. Each zonal railway will develop a customer commitment charter indicating service level commitments to passengers and freight customers. We'll explore the feasibility of opening up of leasing of general purpose wagons, which was today restricted. Although we enjoy the highest captive eyeballs in a railway system globally, we earn less than 5% of our revenues through non-tariff sources. Many of the world railway systems generate anywhere between 10-20%, even 30% of the revenues from this source. Over a period of next 5 years, we'll strive to reach this world average by monetizing assets and undertaking other revenue-yielding activities. We already begun this exercise with a fervor. A major program of station development, redevelopment has been initiated, which I'm sure will convert these huge resources into commercial exploitation of vacant land and space rights over station building. Monetizing land along track is something, an important issue which we are doing. We'll lease out this space to promote horticulture and tree plantation. This will encourage employment to underprivileged sections, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, OBC, etc., augment our food security and also prevent encroachment of railway land. Possibility of using this track for generating solar energy will also be explored. Monetizing soft assets. We collect data pertaining to passenger preferences, ticketing patterns, commodity flows, train running, and information on various services and operations. We are exploring the possibility of monetizing our data software and some of these free services provided by us, such as P&L inquiry, currently being commercially exploited by other players, but at the same time ensuring that no compromise to the customer privacy is made. IRCTC website also offers opportunities for exploring e-commerce activities on account of the large number of hits that it receives. We have vast physical infrastructure which is ripe for commercial exploitation through advertising. We intend to give special focus to exploring advertising potential, trains, stations and land adjacent to track outside the big station. We'll make effort to use customer interfacing assets every manner possible for earning advertising revenue. We'll evolve models to determine the revenue potential of at least 20 stations in the next 3 months. In all, we target to increase advertising revenues by more than 4 times in the current revenue. The parcel business needs to be liberalized, and the current parcel policy, including opening the sector to container train operators, to effect a quantum jump in the share of courier, express and parcel market. Door-to-door connectivity is especially important for this market segment, and we'll take all necessary steps to do this, especially by growing e-commerce business and booking parcel online basis. Manufacturing activity also needs to be properly unlocked, and we have railways to become a meaningful player in the domestic and international market. By 2020, we should aim at generating an annualized revenue of about 4,000 crores by providing these units with necessary empowerment and incentive to realize this target. To ensure participation of large professional players, we have already moved to EPC-based contracting last year. I'm happy to announce that we have finalized the standard document for undertaking works to EPC mode, and this will be done, which will be saving at least all contracts, about 300 crores will be on this basis. Private parties on a non-operational area, they are working with us we intend to look at the contract to make sure that this contract management is to the global standard. In line with international best practices, we will rely on technological solutions for project management and monitoring.